Hello everyone. In this video, let's continue to learn how to code expert advisors. We have learned how to open a chat automatically and how to add indicators automatically in our previous videos. And in this video, we will learn some new APIs, and these APIs will help us to subscribe to the streaming quotes and get the ask and the bid values from the streaming quotes. Okay, let's start learning. The first API is getQuotes. It will subscribe to the streaming quotes. And you know, we can create a chart by using getChartHandle API, right? But we cannot get the streaming quotes even after we have called getChartHandle. So, if we want to get the streaming quotes, we need to call this API. We must call this API. And the name is a little bit confusing actually. This API has no return value. So, please note that this API has no return value. We don't need to store the return value to some variable. Before we get the streaming quotes, we need to call this API once in the init function. The second API that we will learn is getAsk API. This API will help us get the ask values from the streaming codes. And the third API that we will learn is this one, getBid API. This API will return the bid values from the streaming quotes. And the getAsk and the getBid APIs can just be used in the onTick function. So we cannot use both of the functions in the init function or in the dinit function. We just can use them in the onTick function. Okay, this is a very important rule. And another point is, between the callback functions, local variables are not able to be shared. That means, if we want to use some handle or some very important information, such as broker name, account ID, or symbol name, we need to use the window object to store the values. Because just the window object can be shared between the three callback functions. This video is made in 2021. In the latest version, we recommend you use the context object to store the values that you want to share between the callback functions instead of window, so we store the return value into the window object and get the value from the window object and other callback functions. Okay, please remember this very important rule as well. And this API will do this kind of operation. It will subscribe to a streaming quotes. And then get the latest ask and bid values from the streaming quotes, and then calculate the average value according to the quotes. Okay, the logic is very simple. Let's see how it works. We need to copy the source code and then we run it in our console panel. it's done, and then we can find it in our EA list. And then we run it. Now you can see the average value. The average values have been shown here. Okay, so the logic is correct. Okay, we can stop it. The logic is correct and it's done successfully. Hopefully this tutorial video can be helpful. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.